Jazz trail by five.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Taking a look at the Grizzlies. They've got Jaren Jackson, Jake Crowder out there with Clark. Then it's Morant. Chris, when you look around the league, who do you feel is the most universally liked player in the league?
Derrick Rose, fighting all those injuries, coming back, having a 50-point game, becoming the leader again there in Minnesota, the youngest MVP ever, watching his ups and downs, Luka Doncic. How about that guy? Man, that's just an excitement of play. The fact that he's just infused this Dallas team with energy and fun, so much fun watching him, and then you gotta go to the Elder States. In other words, we call him the old head runner. And that's Vince. Jay, Dominique, Jordan, and those dunkers. Anything that's happening today is Garvey's man.
Here's Clark, following the three-pointer by Houston. Memphis moving it around. Checks and misses.
Not easy to keep him from converting those. I mean, the D has to be airtight.
Conley gets the ball. The pass to Morant. Gobert against Jackson. Not loose.
Stolen by Mitchell.
Now here's Conley. Here's Bogdanovich.
I missed that time. Would have put him up.
We expect him to make those. They gotta do more to get ahead in his face next time. That works just like they do with a Tilda Parker. He's short arms to me.
Here's Mitchell. Tight defense on him. They now take the lead. Mitchell's got his third basket of the night right there.
They can learn a lot by watching him operate.
And that one drops.
And he's putting the hammer down. Dominant quarter for him, trying to push out that lead.
And for the Grizzlies, they come in off a good outing against the Bulls.
That mental toughness on the road. The arena was rocking, but they just got down to business and never let up. The noise didn't really seem to bother them. In fact, it appeared to make them sharper and play harder for each other.
Utah calls timeout. As the teams head into this timeout, a chance for the coaches now to...
I love this. spirit he's shown tonight, particularly on the offensive end. And he's gotten to his spots and capitalized. He just needs a little more help from his team.
Here's Mitchell. And the call on the shot sends him to the line.
Well, you might think it's 6'3". Donovan Mitchell is undersized for the shooting guard position. But this combination of strength and length, along with the athleticism, help him to hold his own.
Morant, he's jumped in for Jones. Kept alive. Here's Clark. Whistle blows. Bucket is good. He'll have a chance at the line to make it a three-point play.
In all of his athleticism on display there, Clark's work ethic makes him lethal on that offensive backboard.
Nowadays, teams looking for plus-six players. That's a player whose arm span exceeds their height by at least 6 inches.
Donovan Mitchell, how about a plus-nine? I mean, a little over 6'1 in size with a 6'10 wingspan. Those long arms, the reason for the spider nickname.
A three ball. Hit him up by the hoop. His third miss. He is big too. Clark, the best to work. Some nice passing there by Memphis. Clark dishes to Morant. Conley. Goes to Jackson. He kicks to Murray. And draw from 3-point range. Jazz leading by five. Takes a three. Inbound by Murray.
No other way to put it. Just a poor shooting performance for him. But luckily, his teammates have picked up the slack. And that is a textbook example of how to defend your rim.
So that's why he's out there right now. In situations like this, he stands tall to prevent them.
And here is Conley. He's got 10.
Just can't find it. Touch this quarter. He's got to keep grinding on looking for the best shot possible.
And the whistle blows as the basket counts. And a three-point play chance right here. One free throw coming up.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
The Grizzlies shooting their fifth free throw of the game here.
And collectively, they're only about 73% as a unit right now.
Of plays where you feel the whistle gets blown maybe a little too often and a little short.
But sometimes for a guard, he's the middle guard and the pick and roll comes and fights for that pick. As a guard or an offensive player, I have to stop an issue on base and shoot the ball. I think the ref just have to be smart. Sometimes it's a foul, but every time it's not just because of the situation or the flop. And also, you just don't want players to be bailed out when the defender is in the position. But that's what makes the game so great, is the fact that as an offensive player, you got to try to manipulate and find out where you can sneak yourself in the gray areas of the rules. And as a defensive player, how can you use your skill, your will, and then your IQ not to get caught with your hand in the hoop?
This is when the dry spell continues.
It's been a really tough quarter for him. I mean, he cannot get his shots to drop.
Clark, good, nice job down low. Clark's got 7 now in this quarter.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement. nice job of drawing the contact and creating opportunities at the line.
And so Clarkson will bring it up for Utah. Oklahoma City Thunder will be in town for the next one. That'll be the last of three straight up for the team. Bojan Bogdanović has solidified himself as a key player.
I mean, over 40% from long range in recent years, competes defensively. He's a player.
Shoots from the corner. Count that one. 26 points for him.
Well, this is why Morant's teammates love to play alongside him. I mean, exceptional vision, and he's incredible in himself.
Kyle, lay the pass to go ahead. Here is Connor. Defended by Crowder. Now Connor. He's coming off a 22-point game against the Lakers.
He's able to score as he was in that game. He was aiming for the pass. Not a decision.
Well, shot off that time. Memphis leading by five. Pass to Crowder. Good on the jump shot. Clark's got 11.
And that set them apart today, guys. Their success with the mid-range.
And on our sideline, our reporter, David Ulmer.
Well, Kevin, Jaren Jackson Jr. is the son of an NBA player. I'm so old, I covered his dad in college. Growing up, his parents let him find his passion, but the game was always in his genes. Jackson Jr. said, I always prided myself on being more than just a basketball player. I can't deny my laser focus on the sport. Kevin, he's following in his father's footsteps, but looking to create his own legacy.
Terrific mentor, but he's just getting started, David. Thank you. Looking at who's out there now for the Jazz. George Niang is jabbed in for Bogdanović, and Farrell subbed in for Mike Conley.
I appreciate the question, but that's already his second foul. He's got to play a little safer.
The Grizzlies have gone 4-6 so far for the Rockets.
The potential is there. For Clark, it's a...
Kevin, here with Coach Quinn Snyder. Quinn, what concerned you most about the first half?
Well, I think the tempo is in their favor right now. They're fast, and they're getting up and down the floor. So they're running out in transition.
Got to beat them to the punch. Thanks very much, Coach. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. We'll be back after halftime for the start of the third quarter. Just joining us, we played through the first half in a game that's been fairly even so far. Memphis leading by six. Well, we've got a moment left.